welcome to the PowerSync video series. We're showcasing the subscription management and recurring transactions product built for the Salesforce Sales Cloud. Sales teams cannot function when the data in their CRM, a customer relationship management platform, does not exist, is not up to date, or is inconsistent. Platform users have been getting frustrated for years when confronted with duplicate work in their sales tools. PowerSync has solved this frustration by automating necessary flows, which help save time and enable your sales teams to work smarter and not harder. Before we came along, CRM clients had to fix data manually or buy an expensive and sometimes a cumbersome product like CPQ, even if all features and functionality were not needed. In many cases, they also had to hire Salesforce developers to create custom solutions because of staffing and quality complexities. Hearing from the Salesforce Sales Cloud community and how they struggled, PowerSync took note and listened to the most vocal concerns, creating a skeleton of a perfect solution. The quick demo you're about to see covers what we've learned about the desired flexibility, ease of use, data integration, and automation within Salesforce Sales Cloud. As a result of our solution, PowerSync clients are saving thousands of hours annually and in some cases even quarterly. This cost reduction roughly translates to 1 to 3 full-time employee equivalent who use their time to do duplicate work. So let's get started. In the next few minutes, we're going to help our sales representative work smarter by automating manual steps that are often skipped or overlooked. We will start with a well-known sales process where a sales representative has an opportunity for their account. Let's imagine our account is MI6, and the opportunity is for James Bond, the famous 007 agent who takes missions to save the world. Looking at the Salesforce Sales Cloud, and specifically looking at the opportunity record for weekly support operations for 007 agent, I pre-populated this opportunity with a few products, AA batteries, medkits, snacks. You will also notice that I have James Bond linked as a contact to this opportunity, and the opportunity is currently set to prospecting stage. For the subscription management product that I'm demoing, you will notice that I have a new button called New Subscription Profile added to the opportunity view. Clicking that button will trigger the process to translate this opportunity into a subscription profile, which is a custom object within the Salesforce Sales Cloud. Let's go ahead and click on that. You will be presented with a screen to populate some additional information that will be necessary for our subscription profile. The first thing that we need to do is we need to set the billing frequency schedule for this particular subscription profile. In our case, we do know that James Bond wants to receive these products on a weekly basis. Let's also say James Bond wants to cancel the subscription on April 20th this year. This field is optional in case the subscription profile should be infinite. The next thing you will notice is 3 products that were on the opportunity got pulled into the subscription profile. At this stage, you can set the quantities, remove products, change pricing, and so on and so forth. After you're done, you have 2 options, either to create a subscription profile or create and activate. Create and activate triggers some additional automation that you can configure in our configuration screen. So for this demo, let's go ahead and click on create and activate. What you will see happen is a newly created subscription profile will be presented to you with all the metadata we need to know, specifically which opportunity the subscription profile came from, what is the default price book, what is the billing contact account, and so when is the renewal date, and so on and so forth. You will also notice that on the subscription profile, we now have the 3 products that got pulled in from the opportunity and the sales prices. This list of products can be changed at any point, even mid through the subscription profile cycle. And you will also notice under the related tab, we have our first order that got created and the payment transaction for that order was captured through the automation. These 2 automatic processes were configured for this demo. You have the flexibility of not creating an order or not capturing the payment and doing that manually through your integration with other point of sales or payment gateways and things like that. We also can come back to the opportunity from which the subscription profile was created. And when we reload the screen, we notice that the opportunity automatically got changed to the closed one status to mark the completion of this sale, so to speak. The next thing that I will demo is, let's say there is a different order which James Bond placed a week ago for the same product, same amount, and we know we actually want to associate this order with the newly created subscription profile. It's a historical order, we just need to link the two together. So for this, the way that you will make this happen is you will notice that there is a associated with a subscription profile button at the top. Let's go ahead and click on that button. You will be presented with an easy pop-up window where you will select the subscription profile you want to associate this order with. You will notice that the renewal on date was pre-populated from the subscription profile. Given that this is a historical order, we don't need to change the renewal on date. We'll leave it the same. We do want to capture a payment transaction record because we do know that James Bond did pay with a check for this particular order. So let's make sure we set the correct payment type to check. The payment date will remain the same. The check has cleared, and let's say the check number was 12345. So after filling out all of this information, let's go ahead and click on link order. You will notice that the order automatically goes into the paid status. This is done per configuration. You will also notice the payment transaction record got created and set to complete status. And now if we go back to the subscription profile and reload this page, and navigate back to the related tab, we now see two orders, two payment transactions records, and this will make our subscription profile complete. Next time when the renewal date happens, let's say on January 9th in our scenario, a new order will be created automatically and set to the appropriate status based on your configuration. And if you've configured to capture payment transactions, those will be created automatically as well. This concludes our demo. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and stay tuned for other PowerSync videos in the future.